Hello everyone, welcome to physics class with a new topic, refraction. In previous lecture, we cover reflection of light in plane mirror, spherical mirror, mirror formula and linear magnification and its numericals. So now, let's start this lecture. Look at those pictures so you can easily relate what I am saying. Now students, look to picture 1. If we take a pencil or a spoon and immerse in water, somehow it look bent. Now go to picture 2. When light passes from air to water medium, it deviates from its path. This is called as bending of light, and this phenomena is called refraction of light. Now go to picture 3. If rays passes through a glass slab, the emergent ray deviates or shifted to its actual path. This shift is called as lateral shift. We later elaborately study on it. This is also happen due to bending of light or refraction of light. Now go to picture 4. If a coin is immersed in water or a fish inside a pond, it appears like the object is nearer to us, but actually they have placed certain distance from its apparent position or certain distance from us. Then in next picture, twinkling of stars is also an example of refraction of light. This is the atmospheric refraction. Also, another example of atmospheric refraction, that sun is visible before actual sunrise, also visible after sunset. This is due to the atmospheric refraction. Another most popular example, that is mirage formation. That mirage formation in desert is also due to refraction of light. Next, if we take a bottle which is filled of water, go to that picture. You see that picture, and a hole is there. Through that hole, water is come outside, and here in that hole, that laser beam is passes. So continuously that laser beam bent. This is also refraction of light. That we know that light ray is passes always in a straight line path, but here that laser light continuously bend. This is the application of refraction of light. These are the examples of our day-to-day life. All this happens due to refraction of light. So let's understand refraction of light. Now first we go to discuss definition of refraction of light. If a light passes from one transparent medium to another transparent medium but having oblique incident, then it deviates its path. This bending of light due to the change of medium, this phenomena is called as refraction of light. That means the phenomena of bending of light ray, the phenomena of bending of light ray due to the change of medium is known as refraction of light. Here what happens? When light passes from one transparent medium to another medium, at that case it bent. And how it bent? We go to that next one. Now here discuss three cases. That how the light bent when it passes from one medium to another medium. So let's start the
case 1, the first case, when a light ray passes from optically rarer medium, optically rarer medium to optically denser medium. So here the ray, this one is the actual path of the ray, but when that ray passes from rarer to denser medium, in denser medium it deviates its actual path and bent towards the normal. This one is the normal, okay, this one is the normal, and here that ray bent towards the normal, and here this angle is the angle of incident and this angle is the angle of refraction. Here that incident angle is greater than refraction angle, because here this one is angle of incident and this one is the angle of incident is equal, this angle is equal to this total angle. But as that ray is bent towards the normal, that angle of refraction is smaller compared to angle of incident. So angle of incident is greater than angle of refraction, and this angle is called as angle of deviation and denoted by delta, called as angle of deviation. Now go to case 2, when that light ray passes from denser medium to rarer medium, optically denser medium to rarer medium. In rarer medium, it bent its actual path or deviated from its actual path and went away from the normal. This one is the actual path of the incident ray, but the refracted ray went away or go away from the normal, and this one is the angle of refraction and here this one is the angle of incidence. So here in this case, angle of refraction is greater than angle of incidence. Now go to another case, that case 3. Here what happened? When a light ray passes normal to the interface, this one is called as interface. So what do you mean by interface? The imaginary line which separates two medium. The imaginary line which separates two medium, that imaginary line is called as interface. When light is perpendicular to the interface or normal to the interface, at that case angle of incident equals to 0, and here that angle of refraction is also 0. That means I is equals to R. There is no deviation occur. In this case, there is no deviation occur. When that ray or light ray passes normal or perpendicular to the interface, at that case no deviation occur. Now next we discuss the laws of refraction of light and why that ray is bent. We discuss later. Laws of refraction of light. The first law, the incident ray, the reflected ray, normal to the point of incidence, at the point of interface, all lie in the same plane. The interface, first one students, this one is the interface. And what is interface? The imaginary line which separates the two media, that is called as interface. The source of light, this one is the incident light, and when the light passes from one medium to another medium, here refraction takes place, and this one is the refracted ray. Okay, this one is the incident ray, this one is the refracted ray. And a perpendicular which we draw at the point of incidence to the interface, this perpendicular is known as normal. This perpendicular is known as normal. All are lie in the same plane. This incident ray, refracted ray, normal at the point of incident to the interface, all lie in the same second law, that second law is also known as Snell's law. What is Snell's law? The ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is always constant. Okay, sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is always constant. Then what is the constant value? That is the ratio of refractive index of second medium to the refractive index of first medium. Then what do you mean by refractive index? If we take this medium, that first medium having refractive index mu1 and the second medium having refractive index mu2, in both case, here case 1 and here case 2, the first medium of refractive index take as mu1 and second medium refractive index take as mu2, then sin I by sin R is equals to that refractive index of second medium to the refractive index of first medium. That is sin I by sin R is equals to refractive index of second medium, that is mu2, by refractive index of first medium mu1. That constant is equals to refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. That is represented as refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. Okay, then as we take this equation, this is equals to mu1 sin I is equals to mu2 sin R. This one is the important formula, that is sin I by sin R equals to mu2 by mu1. That if we cross multiplication this one, mu1 sin I equals to mu2 sin R. Students, here you note down this equation and hear that mu2 by mu1, this refractive index is known as relative refractive index. Next we go to analysis the refractive index. That means what do you mean by refractive index? Okay, so next topic, refractive index.